Welcome to a special edition of Microsoft Mechanics. Coming up on the show, we catch up with Brad Anderson, Microsoft 365 CVP, for a look at the latest updates for endpoint and app management to enable secure remote work experiences from wherever your users are. So Brad, welcome back to Microsoft Mechanics.
Thanks, Jeremy. It's great to be back.
So this is an interesting time, I think, for a lot of us, including those that work in IT or either working remotely at home or maybe on rotation in the office. And the shift to hybrid work environments, it's continuing now, but how is it impacting the work that we're doing in IT for things like managing end user experiences, devices, and security?
You know, this is just a fascinating time to be working on endpoint management, security, end user enablement, you know, because things are changing so quickly. Think about what happened in March. In a matter of a couple of days, everyone was sent home, and then we were participating in the world's largest work from home experiment ever. And you know what happened is organizations pretty quickly realized that some of their processes and some of the things that they depended on for years, you know, such as the firewall and actually being face to face, just didn't work when your users were literally working from everywhere. Now, we're beginning to see organizations come back into the office. But you know, make no mistake, this concept of hybrid work is going to be with us forever. We went through multiple years of cultural change in just March and April. So the design point has to be some of our users are going to be working in the office and some of our users are going to be working from home. Now, from a modern workplace perspective, we have to ensure that independent of where your users are, they can get access to everything that they need to be productive and achieve, but make sure that all of your information is protected and secure.
Why don't we start then with hardware provisioning? So I know that there's some changes there, but what's new?
Yeah, you know, one of the things that everyone realized pretty quickly when the pandemic occurred is much of their hardware was just not up to the task. You know, think about it for a minute. Everybody went from working in the office to now working in teams, you know, 24/7. And there was a run on things like cameras and laptops. You know, in fact, in March and April, you could not find a camera or a laptop if you looked as hard as you could. If you're in a company that takes delivery of laptops, installs Windows and apps on them, then sends out the hardware to people, you know, this process just doesn't work if you wanted to run that type of a build lab from home. Can you imagine receiving dozens of PCs daily to your home, building a lab to provision all that, and then sending it out to your users? And this is where Windows Autopilot comes in. You can drop ship devices directly to your users, whether that's at a work or a home address, and you're in still complete control over the apps and policies that those users get once the user takes delivery. The PC is provisioned over the internet without having to be on the corporate network. And recently, one of the new things we added is the ability to set up co-management as a part of Autopilot. That means that all those apps that you've been managing from Configuration Manager can now easily be deployed as a part of the Autopilot process. So you don't have to migrate your Windows apps to Intune or manage them in two different places. Now check this out. Here I have an OS deployment task sequence for a new computer, and all I have to do is disable or remove the operating system installation tasks, and all these other tasks will work the same. And if you use nested task sequences, you can even use the configuration sequences unchanged. So they'll work via Config Manager or Autopilot provisioning. No build lab is needed. Autopilot will execute all of this as expected. And as a part of the Autopilot process on the endpoint, you'll see this execute part of the enrollment status page. It's just one of the 9 apps listed here. And if you want to, you can just see the task sequence progress UI too, but in my case, we've hidden it.
Nice, so okay, we're familiar then with the concept of co-management, where you can decide different aspects that are managed by either Intune or Configuration Manager. And last time you were on Mechanics, we actually saw something called Tenant Attach, where you get a unified list then of the devices and don't need to choose kind of between one tool or the other. But you can, as you can see here, you can actually initiate things like machine policy and user policy sync directly from the Memadmin Center.
This is a huge update and simplification that enables organizations and customers to attach the Microsoft 365 cloud to their Config Manager deployment. With Tenant Attach, there's nothing that has to happen on the endpoint. It's all done in the admin UI. You, the IT pro, connects an Intune tenant to your Config Manager deployment, and we instantly give you new value, such as the ability to see and take actions on all of your devices from the Microsoft Endpoint Manager console. We've seen a huge uptick in cloud attach, 5% of all Windows devices managed by Microsoft Endpoint Manager a year ago, to literally 19% today. And we see this quickly getting to a third of all devices a year from right now, and soon over half of all the Windows 10 devices managed by Microsoft Endpoint Manager will be cloud attached. So if you're not enabling cloud attached, you are falling behind. good news is there's no transition needed, and you can even execute many of the core Config Manager policies directly from any browser now. Microsoft Endpoint Manager Admin Console is literally that hub that gives you that consolidated view from all of your endpoints. And there's some really cool new things coming. For example, with Timeline, as you can see here, you get all of the interesting events that have happened on a device. This is great for troubleshooting your devices. And that's not the only place we've made the addition of Microsoft Cloud Insights available to your on-prem Config Manager deployment. You know, group policy has been a staple for IT teams for decades in setting settings across Windows and Windows applications. And at the core of group policy are these ADMX files that are used for templates that define all these settings. So last year, we added ADMX back policy management directly into Intune to expose thousands of additional settings. Here we're looking at a configuration profile for Windows 10 with administrative templates selected. We now keep these up to date, not only with the latest Windows policies, but if you look at computer configuration, you see all the policy settings you need to manage Microsoft 365, the Edge browser, Office 2016, which manages everything Office 2016 and newer, as well as your Office 365 apps and OneDrive policies. And these are still delivered via the same policy configuration service, or CSP. So your Windows 10 machines just need to be joined to Endpoint Manager to take advantage of all of this.
Right. And it really blew my mind when I saw those policies light up in Intune. But now with also Office and the Edge ADMX settings in there and up to date, it's more than just control for non-domain joined PCs like you can do here, but it's also a huge time saver.
That's right. And one more thing about these ADMX backed policy files, as you can see here, you can now upload custom ADMX files. You can import third-party ADMX templates and display them in the same GUI experience that I just showed you. And if you've been using Chrome, we're working on a policy setting migration tool that you'll be able to point to your Chrome settings and it'll automatically migrate them over to Edge. As you can see here, we've mapped common settings between what you've set in Chrome to what we have in Edge. And you just choose what you want, and those will be migrated and enforced for Edge. This way, you can start using Edge immediately. You know, I've been saying for the last year that Edge is by far the best browser for business. And I say that for the following reasons. It has greater privacy than Chrome. It has better compatibility because of IE mode that's built right into it. All the management and security of Endpoint Manager and EMS is built into it. And with Microsoft Search, it also gives you that ability to search all your intranet in addition to the internet. It really is the best browser for business. And my recommendation is go make it that by policy across all your devices.
That's right. And I love all the different Edge browser integration and deployment that you've built in to Microsoft Endpoint Manager. In fact, we just published a three-part series on Edge and Microsoft Search at aka.ms/edge4IT.
You know, the browser is such an important part of the management and story that you have for your devices. The common user spends over 60% of their time in the browser and the Office apps. That's where they spend their time on a PC. If you are a user like me of Teams, I spend over 90% of my time in the Office apps and in the browser. And that's why we're building all these Microsoft Endpoint Manager controls directly into these apps, Edge and all the Office apps, so that you get this security and this manageability out of the box. And there's a principle here. It's a lot easier to just use what's been built into these applications for you across all of your applications and devices for security and management. Now, with the pandemic, one common question we've got is organizations say, hey, we have lots of users who want to use their personal PCs and Macs. And we want to enable that, but how do you do that and still protect the data that the users are accessing from these personal and therefore untrusted devices? Well, today we gave a first look at something really exciting that's coming. We're building more Microsoft Endpoint Manager controls into Edge. These controls will enable your users to do things like use the Edge browser to access and use any web apps, like the Office web apps, and we'll be able to ensure that data never leaves the browser or the storage location that you've approved. And just like you can prevent copy and paste out of the Office applications on iOS and on Android, that's an example of a control that we're going to enable in Edge that has these Microsoft Endpoint Manager controls built into it for any web app. Here I have my corporate email open on my unmanaged personal device. Now I'm signed in with my Microsoft 365 account in Outlook and in the Edge browser. If I go and I copy this text from this Edge window and then try to paste it into another Edge window where I'm signed in with my personal account here on Twitter, you'll see it doesn't work. And that's because my organization has blocked it. Again, this is an unmanaged device and policy management is happening directly from Edge at the app layer.
And that's great that this protection is now baked into Edge, which expands then data loss prevention or DLP now to unmanaged devices as well. So that changes a lot of things, but is there anything new then for the managed devices?
You know, Jeremy, as you know, one of the things that I've been on a mission for the last couple of years is helping organizations improve their end user experience. You know, as we've researched this, one of the things that we've seen is these DLP agents that have come from this, the traditional security vendors are the agents that often have the biggest impact on end user experience. So what we've done in Microsoft 365 is we've built a modern DLP solution that delivers you all the DLP capabilities that you need in that protection, but it does it in a way that doesn't have that impact on the endpoint. We call this endpoint DLP, and it doesn't just give you DLP protection in the Office apps, it gives you data protection device-wide. Now, here's an example of a confidential document endpoint DLP policy. In my case, even if I try to copy content into the clipboard, it's blocked because this document has sensitive information. From the Microsoft 365 Compliance Center, I only need to define one policy that spans apps and devices. Like other DLP policies, I can monitor block with user-permitted override or outright block. You can also see I have options here for uploading, copying to USB, and printing. And again, unlike other solutions out there that dramatically slow down your PC, Endpoint DLP does not.
Okay, so we've covered now the core updates for deployment, policy management, information protection, with things like DLP, but what have we done, or have we done anything actually to help the day-to-day kind of help desk or desktop support professionals that are out there?
You know, a massive focus for us for some time has been building analytics and insights so we can actually give you, you know, those views into how your organization is working and the experience you're delivering to your users. Here you can see in productivity score, which gives you recommendations on how to improve things like meetings or how your people are collaborating. Now, the part of productivity score that my team delivers is called Endpoint Analytics. Now, this is a place we're putting massive investments. Endpoint Analytics helps you to understand both device and app health state. We give you data-driven recommendations on how you can improve your end user's experience in places such as the boot time. Now, one thing that's brand new that you're going to see in Endpoint Analytics is what we call Application Help. Application Help is a very unique capability in Microsoft Endpoint Manager. Whenever a PC crashes and the user is asked if they want to upload that data back to Microsoft so we can learn, it comes back to what we call Dr. Watson. Now, it's interesting. The software engineer that's responsible for that portion of the code is notified as crashes come in so that they can actually track and resolve the issue. Then we kind of track it end to end. Now, what we've done is we've wired up your Microsoft Endpoint Manager tenant to Dr. Watson, so we can now show you your personalized view of what is causing crashes in your PC estate, along with the specific actions to take to reduce the number of crashes. And if we look across apps for app performance, you can drill into the details and see, for example, things like performance across different app versions, including what the mean time to failure is. Now, let's even take that one step further. One of the areas that we've been working on is give you the ability to be able to create scripts that will proactively go out and remediate issues even before you see it. We call this proactive remediations. You can reduce calls to your help desk and improve the end user experience by proactively creating automation scripts that detect and fix issues before your users see them. You can see issue remediation trends over time. And here's one that shows a common one to update stale group policies, and we can choose how often it runs. I can even drill into the script itself. Now, customers are using these proactive remediation scripts and often seeing up to a 50% reduction in the associated help desk calls.
Okay, so then speaking of VPN, what are we doing then to help with VPN on our mobile devices?
Yeah, you know, one of the other big announcements that we made today is something that we call the Microsoft Tunnel. Microsoft Tunnel is built into Microsoft Endpoint Manager MAM controls, and it enables your users to securely access your content behind your firewall when they launch an app that requires that on-prem access. Here you're seeing the new Microsoft Tunnel Gateway configuration in Microsoft Endpoint Manager. After you input a name, you just choose the new Microsoft Tunnel as the connector type. Then you define the connection name or IP or domain name. And we let you configure this as either an always-on VPN or a per-app VPN. And here I'm just going to go ahead and select Edge. And this seamlessly and securely gives you access to content behind the firewall. We can enable the always-on VPN or just have the app trigger it as well as the proxy settings if needed. All right, now let's take a look at the experience on a phone. So here I've got my Duo, and I'm going to go into an internet-hosted internal app, as you can see by the IP address in Chrome here on the right-hand side, and you'll see that it doesn't work. It's unreachable. Now on the left screen, I'm going to open up that same IP address in Edge, and you'll see that it works. Simple and secure access to your data and applications behind the firewall.
Okay, but let's switch gears then to security. What are we doing then on the device security front?
Now, with the integration that we've done between Microsoft Endpoint Manager and Microsoft Defender for Endpoint, you're going to see how this all continues to come together. Now, you might recognize this as Defender ATP, but as of today, the name going forward will be Microsoft Defender for Endpoint. Here's an example of Defender running on my Surface Duo, and I'm installing a test virus app here. And you can see that Microsoft Defender finds it, and if we tap in, we can see that it's unsafe. And the great thing here is that with Microsoft Defender, you get this complete view of incidents and alerts. So I'm in the Microsoft Defender Security Center, and you'll see the alerts are here, including the one from my phone. If I click into it, you get all the rich details about what the threat is and the details that Defender took to remediate it. Now in Microsoft Endpoint Manager, you can connect Defender for Endpoint with Microsoft Endpoint Manager and have that complete view for your Windows, Mac, iOS, and Android devices all in one experience.
And all these updates you've presented today are really going to help in terms of management across devices from wherever people are working. But what else, other tips would you leave people today with as they manage the user experiences, devices, and security?
You know, there are two big takeaways I really kind of encourage people to go do. The first one is go tenant attach your Config Manager deployment to Intune. That enables to start to flow down all this cloud-delivered insights to you. And the second thing is go set Edge as your preferred and recommended browser for accessing your organization's data.
Thanks, Brad. It's always a pleasure having you on the show. And you can get started with everything that we saw in Microsoft Endpoint Manager as an admin by going to endpoint.microsoft.com and make Endpoint Manager your hub for IT. And we hope that we can answer all of your questions, and also be sure to stay up to date with the latest tech news from Microsoft. You're going to want to subscribe to Microsoft Mechanics. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.